Hi, hello, welcome. My name is Ariel. I am a market coordinator at the National Institute of Tourism Promotion of Argentina, the Impro Tour. This time we would like to introduce Natalia. She is from Salta, also Impro Tour Salta. Hello, Natalia, how are you?
Hi, Ariel, how are you? Fine, and you?
Fine, thank you. Well, we are very happy this time that we are have the presentation of Salta. This time it's a beautiful area of our country. It's one of the most beautiful states that we have, so we are going to enjoy a lot this presentation. Just a few advice: on the control panel you will find a place that you can ask some questions to us, so you can write there, and at the end of the presentation we are answering all of them. Other things, we are going to start with a short video of Argentina. At this time we want to invite you to travel from home, so take care and let's see the video. Thank you.
Hoy te invitamos a que viajes. Sí, escuchaste bien. A que viajes con la mente. Que cierres los ojos y te veas en un avión viajando a ese lugar que tanto soñaste. Qué linda sensación, ¿no? De libertad, de aventura, con esa adrenalina de conocer una maravilla natural. Montañas, lagos, salinas. Sentir la sensación de caminar sobre un glaciar o de llegar al fin del mundo. Todo está en tu mente. Podés llegar, solo tenés que soñarlo para que pronto se haga realidad. Desde tu casa, solo, en familia o con amigos, porque aunque estemos distanciados, hoy estamos más cerca que nunca, soñando un mismo sueño. Viaja desde tu casa.
Well, great. Travel from home. Our wish is that we could travel again and the tourism start to improve again and travel everybody. So, Natalia, this is all for you. So, just it's your presentation. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, Ariel. Okay. Thank you very much for sharing this moment with us. And thank you for letting us to show you my province. Yes. Today, we are going to present our destination, Salta. Okay, the province of Salta is located at the northwest of Argentina. Yes, let me show you in this part. It's bordered with three countries: Bolivia, yes, Bolivia, Chile, and Paraguay. And six provinces: Jujuy, Formosa, Chaco, Tucumán, Catamarca, por acá, and Santiago del Estero. Yes. Salta has an international land connection with the north of Chile through Paso de Sico in the province of Salta and Paso de Jama in the province of Jujuy in the north. And also has an international land connection with the south of Bolivia through Pocitos and Aguas Blancas. Yes? In the province of Salta, operate different airlines such as Aerolíneas Argentina, LATAM, Andes Líneas Aérea, Flybondit and JetSmart. But remember, this was before the COVID-19, yes? After the COVID, I don't know what kind of thing, what happened. Okay, these airlines connect us with main cities of Argentina, like Buenos Aires, Iguazú, Puerto Madryn, Córdoba, Mendoza, Neuquén, and Ushuaia. But also we can get to the other part of the world because also we have international connections to Panama with Copa Airlines and Lima with LATAM. And the province of Salta also offers different kinds of activities and attractions to visit. For example, we have the Cabildo. It's this building, El Cabildo. It's one of the oldest buildings in the city, dating from the 16th century. Today, the Historical Museum of the North works inside it. Yes, and you can visit every day. San Francisco Church, as you can see, is a beautiful, beautiful building. It's a gorgeous church, and is one of the main tourist attractions of the city for its beauty and historical importance. The church has the tallest tower in the South America with 54 meters. This is the tower. This is the tallest tower in South America. And actually, or today, also you can visit in this church and museum, and in the museum can tell you about the Franciscan Order. It's very interesting to visit this place. Other place that you can visit if you come here to Salta is the Archaeological Museum. It's known like MAM, and these museums preserve three Inca children. The children were offered at 6,730 meters above sea level at the peak of a mountain that calls Yuyayaco. For 5 centuries, they were buried in this place and kept the secrets of an important ritual. Today, we are able to better understand the life of the Inca, the Inca ancestors. It's one of the museums most important to visit. And in this museum, you can learn about the life of the Inca, yes? Then here, we have the Museum of Güemes. Güemes was a national hero. And this museum is one of the most visited museums. It's an interactive museum, yes? And Güemes also was a gaucho who fought in the war for our independence, yes? And here, we have the cable car that calls San Bernardo. The cable car gets to the top of the hill that called Cerro San Bernardo, the Hill San Bernardo, and from the top you have the panoramic view of the city. You have a beautiful, beautiful view from the top. And Salta, the province of Salta, has a variety of accommodation from 5 to 1 star hotels. And also we have the boutique hotel, yes? And this hotel offers different kind of facilities. In the north of Argentina or in the region of the north in Argentina, Salta has the major numbers of hotels, okay? Salta has a mix of culture. This is over the difference with our province. We have a mix of culture, the culture of our native people, the gaucho, and the Spanish people. As you can see here, you can see the gaucho. It's famous in the world. And if you visit our province, you can enjoy different culture activities, like Pachamama ritual. Is this activity the old people, our ancestor people, the carnivals, yes, for example here, the carnivals, and the other festivals bring from the Spanish people. For example, we have one of the most important festivity is the procession in honor of our patrons, the Lord and Virgin of Miracles. The Lord and Virgin of Miracle.
Natalia, sorry. Is it possible to tell us the date of the carnival and also of the Pachamama Day?
Oh, sorry. Yes, the Pachamama is usually in August. Yes, the first days of August is the ritual of Pachamama. But you can enjoy this activity all August. And the carnival we have in the summer. Yes, in February you can enjoy the carnival from the province of Salta, our typical carnival. As you can see, the imagine is not the, for example, the most carnival or the most visited carnival in the world is the carnival of Rio de Janeiro, of course. But here in our province, as you can see, the carnival is very typical from here. Yes, and the Pachamama is a ritual that we offer some things like meal or some beverage or cigarette to the land. Yes, because in our ancestors believe in the land. Yes, like a god. Yes, or similar a god. Yes, so with this ritual, the people say thanks to the mother and gifts for the rains and for the good of the community. Yes, do you understand me?
Okay. Yes, perfect. Thanks.
Okay, you're welcome. Okay, continuing to the Lord's Ambition of Miracle. The Lord's Ambition of Miracle are in our cathedral. The cathedral is in the center of the city, opposite in the main square, in the heart of the city. Yes? The procession is celebrated every September 15th. It's one of the deepest and most authentic expression of faith in Latin America. September is different in the province of Salta. Okay, but also you can enjoy the nature in our province. Salta has a diversity geography from the Puna to the jungle. We have the different geography, for example, the High Andes from the Bolivia to the north of Neuquén province, and they suffer extremely dry climate and cold winds. Also, we have the Puna. The Puna is the second high plateau in the world after Tibet. And we have the Yunga Forest. Yes, all these parts, we have the Yunga Forest. And in the province of Salta, you can find three national parks. The National Park El Rey, and the park was created in 1948, and it is in the Yungas ecoregion, with a sample of the dry Chaco and covers an area with more or less 44,000 hectares. And this park is a good place to observe the fauna and flora. And inside you can do some activities like trekking. Here, as you can see in this part, you can see part of the flora and the fauna that you can find in our province. For example, in the National Park El Rey, you can find the tapir, yes. And the National Park Los Cardones, it's here, the National Park Los Cardones. This park was created in 1996. The ecoregions represent the high Andean Puna, part of the Mont, and a small patch of Yungas, and it covered more or less 64 hectares. This park was created to preserve the cardons, and the cardon lived from 250 to 300 years and grows from 1 to 5 centimeters per year. Okay. We have the National Park Baritu. The park was created in 1974 and it protects an area of Yunga forest, and it has 72 hectares, and the climate is mountain and tropical with a dry season. The National Park Baritu, also, you can find some animals like the jaguarete or the monkey, yes? And this part or this feature is part of the flora of the National Park Baritu. Yes, the National Park Baritu is not so accessible to get. So you need to, at least 2 days to get to this place. But I think it is one of the best because it's preserved, because it's not so easy and you need a lot of time to get to this place. And also in all the province of Salta, you can do the activities, the bird watching. Salta has 667 species of birds, which represent the 67th of the country's birds. Yes? Not only in part of the jungle or the rainforest you can see the different birds, also in the Puna, you have a big variety of birds that you can see. For example, here you have the parina. Yeah, the parina, you can find these kind of animals in part of the Puna. And in all, Argentina has 16 endemic species and 13 are found in Salta. The Calchaquí violet, we found the highest wild root. And it is it has more than 20 vineyards that you can visit and enjoy all wines. This is all this part of the Calchaquí Valley. Here in this part, you can see better the valley. From here, also you can see some landscapes that you can find when you are going to this part of the Calchaquí Valley. Yes? Quebrada de las Conchas is this part, located on the way to Cafayate, one of the most important localities inside the valley. And this area has great scenic beauty. And as you can see, this is a rock formation and also has geoformas such as Garganta del Diablo or Anfiteatro. And another way to get to know Salta is through the community rural tourings. The community offers different kinds of activities, like, for example, land tillage, make sweets, craft wine, and regional food. So you spend some time with the family that live in this place, and this family receive you in their home and offer, and you can share with them the activities that you can do every day. Yes, for example, make some empanadas, humitas, tamales. Yes, or make your own wine. Sorry. Also in Cafayate, also you can find the Museum of Vine and Wine. This museum shows the geography of the valley and also the history and process of making high altitude wines. In the province of Salta, you can find different and a variety of wines, or yes, like the Tanat, Cabernet Sauvignon, El Syrah. But our emblematic wine is the Torrontés. The Torrontés is a white wine, it's a light yellow wine. I don't know, I know here, yes, you have a picture from the wine, yes? Sometimes develops golden and green nuances with aromas of flowers such as the rose and jasmine. Yes, this is one of the characteristics of this particular wine, because this wine is different because it's not so easily to find in the world. Yes, only you can find here in the province of Salta, and also we had in the province of La Rioja. And Salta is very, very famous for its the gastronomy. Salta offers the richest and tastiest dishes of the popular cuisine. Can do some activities, such as taking a regional cooking class. Salta invites you to live a unique experience, learning the process of making your our typical dishes. Yes, our typical dishes in the province of Salta are empanadas, humitas, tamales, locro. Yes, and in all the country, the typical is the asado and the dulce de leche. And now, let me show you other part of our province. This is part of the Puna, this place that's called Sola Grande. It's a beautiful, beautiful place. And this town is located in the heart of the Puna. You need more or less from the city of Salta 8 hours to get to this place, but it's beautiful. And you can see other places like Ojos de Mar. This is the Ojos de Mar that is in Tola Grande. They are salty lagoons. In the past, the people thought that these lagoons were connected to the Pacific Ocean. But really, these lagoons are very important because there are these stromatolitos, and this is very important to the atmosphere. Yes? And here, you can see other town that's called Iruya. It's a town hanging in the mountain. Yes? When you get to Iruya, you see this picture. Yes? It's a town in the middle of the mountain. It's a very nice and very quiet town. It's not so far from the province, the city of Salta, sorry. Yes? Another place that you can visit or you can do in the Puna of Salta is excursion and take the train to the cloud. This is the third train, highest in the world, before China and Peru. The train to the clouds of these excursions starts in the city of Salta. In the city of Salta, we had almost 1,200 meters above sea level. And if you take this excursion, you can get to 4,220 meters above sea level in the Viaduct de la Polvorilla. So you need all day if you need to take or if you want to take this excursion. This excursion starts at 6:15 a.m. In this time, you need to do the check-in from the city of Salta, and at 7 a.m., depart by bus to San Antonio de los Cobres. San Antonio de los Cobres is a locality more or less 170 kilometers from the city of Salta. But when are you going to San Antonio de los Cobres, this excursion stops in the middle of the road. For example, at 9:30, stop to breakfast in a place that's called El Alfarcito. El Alfarcito is a small town and it's very beautiful. And when you go from Salta to San Antonio de los Cobres, you, when you are going, you can see the landscape are changing because you are passing from one part of the geography to the other part. Because in the city of Salta, we are in part of the valley. And when you go to San Antonio de los Cobres, you are in part of the Puna. So as you can see in this landscape, the landscape is very different to the city of Salta, okay? And then the excursion gets to this place, the Viaduct La Polvorilla. The Viaduct La Polvorilla has the same altitude that the obelisk in Buenos Aires. Yes. As you can see, you have a variety of landscapes because we have different part of the geography. We have the geography from 200 to 300 meters above sea level to more than 4,000 meters above sea level. Also, you can do different activities like rafting or canopy, yes? Extreme sport, if you like these kind of activities. And you can do this activity all the year. Salta also is ideal for organizing business and social events. We had almost 20,000 places and infrastructure for holding events. Salta is the fourth largest host city in the country, with more than 400 national and international events in 2019. This is the Centro Convenciones, the convention center, and has a capacity for 3,300 people. Salta, as you can see, Salta has a great biodiversity and has the possibilities of providing the visitor with a unique experience in a few kilometers away. We can be in the middle of the mountain or the jungle, and you can observe the different vegetation that you can find here. This place is very near from here, from the city of Salta. So if you are here in the city, also you have very near places where you can do different kind of activities and different parts of our geography. Okay, so this is more or less a little information about our province. So thank you for much. For your attention, and I hope when you come here to visit our province. Thank you so much.
Great, thank you, Natalia. Thank you to all the Salta team. Now we are going to introduce with a Salta video, and then when we come back, we are going to answer all the questions. We have so many, so just stay there, please. Thank you. With this great video, everybody knows why Salta is called the Linda, the beauty, because it's very, very beautiful. So thanks a lot, Natalia. So now we are going to start with some of the questions. Okay, let me start. Give me just 1 second. The train to the clouds run from Salta to where and how long for a day trip?
The excursion to the train to the clouds starts here in the city of Salta, and you need all day because it starts more or less at 6 a.m. here, from the city of Salta, and get to San Antonio de los Cobres more or less at midday, and then you have more or less 2 or 3 hours to enjoy the place of San Antonio de los Cobres, and then back to the city of Salta. At more or less 8 or 9 p.m. are you getting here in the city of Salta. You need a lot of time because from the city of Salta to San Antonio de los Cobres, we have different geography. And when you go from Salta to San Antonio, it's more or less 170 kilometers. But, I'm sorry.
That's right.
But you need more or less 4 hours to do only 170 kilometers. So you need a lot of time, but it's a very, very nice trip, very nice excursions, and you can see different kind of landscape. It's very nice.
Okay, and it's all year around, right?
You need all day.
Sorry? Okay, perfect. No, it's all year around. You can do it every time of the year. There is a schedule, right, on the website. You can find all the information.
Yes, in this moment of the year, yes. Not now, but then, yeah.
Yes, everything stopped, but yes, the regular time, yes. Okay, another one. How's the weather year round and the best time to visit the province?
You can visit the province all year, yes. We have different moments to visit, but our rain season is from December to March. So in this time of the year, sometimes the excursions can be difficult to do. Yes, but you can visit all year.
Okay, and two more questions very close to this one because they are asking about the weather in August and another one, the weather in September.
And we are in August, September
of North America. So we are now starting the winter. So yes, all year, sorry.
No, sorry, Maria. But in August, it's a very nice the weather here in the city of Salta or in the province because it's not so cold and also it's not so hot, so it is very nice. Also September is very different this month, maybe because here we had a very important festivity and all the people that live here in the province of Salta are very religious, and it's very different in September. It's a very nice this month to visit the province.
Great. Well, another one. How can we get to the valleys, bus, car, and how many times to get there?
The Calchaquí Valley. The Calchaquí Valley you can visit by bus or by car. If you don't have the car, here in the city of Salta, we have the different agencies of rent a car. If you want, also you can do with some excursions with the guy, and the guy can tell you about the history, the geography, the different things, because in the Calchaquí Valley you can find not only in the landscape, also you have part of the culture, the history, these places or this part of the place was inhabited for the Indian groups. So it's very rich in all the information in the Calchaquí Valley.
Okay, another one. How long time is necessary for a regular tour? So how many days?
Regular tour in all the province or in the city of Salta?
Yeah, in all the province, I suppose.
Oh, in all the province. Here you have a lot of places and you need only one day. But if you want to enjoy in this place, for example, to go Cafayate, but you can enjoy the life in Cafayate and learn about the culture, I think you need more time. I think 10 days, 14 days for all the province and do all these places. I think 10 days is good to do all these things. But also if you have, for example, less days, for example, 4 or 5 days, also you can do different activities. Yes, but remember, in the city of Salta, you need at least 1 day, because it's very interesting, all the city of Salta to visit, yes?
Okay, and another one very close also with this one is it possible to combine Salta with other destinations in the same region?
Yes, usually the people that come here to the city of Salta stay here, but also take some excursion to other points. For example, the Jujuy, the Gorge of the Humahuaca, is one of the most visited places, and also in Tucumán, de los Valles Calchaquí, part of the Valle Calchaquí, in Tafí del Valle, for example, is other province that visit the people that come here to the city of Salta.
Okay, well, perfect. Then they are asking some information specific of regular tours or excursion that we are going to send that information by email. This webinar is recording, so everybody has access. Tomorrow you will receive an email with the link to check again, you can see it again, and maybe you can share with your partner, so there's no problem. I want to thank you, Natalia, for this magnificent presentation. Thanks to all the assistants also. And this is yours, Natalia, to say goodbye. Thanks.
Thank you so much. It's very difficult for me to do this kind of presentation because I cannot see you. Thank you if I am very nervous. Okay, yeah, but well. I hope you can here to the city of Salta, because I can tell you about our province, but it's very different when you are here in the place and you can feel the place, and the people here is very kind. So I hope you can come here in the province of Salta. Okay, and thank you so much for stay and share this time with us.
Perfect. So stay there. We are closing with another video of Argentina for the end, and then you have also questionnaire. Okay, thanks a lot and see you next time. Bye bye.
Estamos esperando esos momentos, el de volver a sentir los rayos de sol en nuestra cara, respirar ese aire fresco por las mañanas, sentir la naturaleza que nos rodea, el comenzar de una nueva aventura o ese momento íntimo de conectarnos con nosotros mismos. Volver a brindar con amigos y bailar con desconocidos. Esperamos en casa, de norte a sur, de este a oeste, en cada rincón de Argentina. Esperamos que vuelvas al fin del mundo. O quizás al principio de todo. Viaja desde tu casa.